Mm-hmm. Yup. You're looking at it. Uh-huh, I'm back. With a little bit of Dwarf Fortress. Adventure mode. Where I got started. Oh yeah. Alright, so I haven't done any adventure mode in quite a while. Mostly because it was horribly and completely mangled after the Dwarf Fortress 2010 came out. But they've made some significant changes. Let's give it another go, shall we? This is the very first game I've ever recorded and put up on YouTube. 5,000 some odd subscribers ago, 3 million video views ago, and over a year ago of doing this here thing. So it'll be nice and fun to go ahead and get back to it. I'm going to be playing no mods. I got a tile set. Just, you know, have a good old-fashioned adventure. Don't know how long it'll be. Don't know what's going to happen. Could be 2 videos. Could be 200,000 videos. I'm going to go ahead and lean towards the latter, but we'll see. All right, so I generated a new world, and already there's a difference here. On the side, you've got a status where you can choose peasant, hero, and demigod. I imagine that has something to do with the difficulty level of the game, because I noticed that after 40D, 2010 was ridiculously easy. It was almost impossible to die if you had any kind of armor, I mean even leather armor, and if you had a shield you were immortal. So I'm going to play it on hero and hope that they've made a few changes. We will be playing as a human to start out. Actually, we'll do that. I'm going to start out, I'll try it on hero, but I'm going to go with a less awesome profession, so we're going to have a little throwaway guy here, just to do. I've only played one character through on this, so start down here in the southwestern corner. We're going to give ourselves some strength. There's a huge difference in character creation. There's all these different things like linguistic ability, memory, patience. I have no idea what any of this shit does. But we're going to change our strength, agility, toughness, and endurance. We'll give ourselves some kinesthetic sense, which I imagine has something to do with agility and spatial sense too. Although I could be completely wasting these points. Don't really care. I'll go ahead and put the rest of these into strength. I can. No, I can't. I can't. It's lame. Like that. I guess I'll take one out of endurance and put it into agility. There we go. So, there's all sorts of different abilities here, too. Pikeman, bowman, all that stuff. But there's also striker, kicker, biter, thrower, miscellaneous, and whatever a napper is. We're going to be a biter. So, I'm going to put most of my points into biting, but I'll put a couple into kick, strike, and fight. But I'm going to put a lot into wrestle and dodge, armor, and I'm going to put some into swimming because I don't want to drown. Let's see here. I can take one out of hell. No, I want to be a proficient biter. I'll be a novice fighter. No, that's stupid. I'll take one out of armor. Put it into swimming. There we go. Alright, so let's see here. I don't know if that is a male or... That one looks like it's got a dingleberry on it. Maybe that's a male, I don't know. Veil Spiral. Let's see if we can get lucky here. Let me get some other music going here. If that's even possible. Alright. Same old music we used for the latter end of Dwarf Fortress and the stuff I used for the IL2 thing. You know me, I'm all about tradition. So let's see here. Date Dabbled, Stray Chances, Gloucester, Subtle Kindness, Trampled Cherishes, Misty Band, Sensual Amuse. That's euphemistic. Caged Vine, Nested Carnal, Love Ghosts. Drum Pants! Not Drum Pants. I'll take it. I think that's a... I don't know what... I mean, it's got this little dingleberry here, and I think that means I'm a dude, but we'll find out. So I think that's it. We are Nod Drum Pants, the human biter. I think I'll have to create the custom profession there. You finally got your equipment together, such as it is, and now it's time for action and adventure. In the rush of the excitement, you've forgotten where you were going to go. Perhaps some of your friends here have ideas. Press question mark for help. No. I don't need question mark help. So I had to do a couple of little tweaky things here. That music is a bit too hectic for me. What are we on here? Is this some sort of furrowed... I think this is like a farm plot belonging to this hamlet here. One of the problems I had doing a little test recording with this is that if I was using fraps and I hit arrow key to move once, it would move me like 5 tiles at once. So I've had to change the way that it controls key movement, so I can't hold down a key at all. Jesus, look at all these fucking people. I'm using the, I can't remember the name of the graphics pack, but I'm using one. A lot of milkers in here. I don't even want to know what... It smells like sex in here. I'm leaving. You guys are fucking gross. Milking each other. Alright, let's go find another hut that's not so full of milkers. What road is this? This is... I can't see unless I'm on it. This is the road of hop. Nod Drumpence, trotting the road of hop. So there should be another little hamlet up here somewhere. Yeah, man. Let me go. Let me up. There we go. Yeah, it's a little bit funky in the way that it controls the movement and things. But anyway, what I'm going to do is, I know a lot of you guys can't handle this sort of game, graphically speaking. Alright, a butcher, a bone carver. This one's even worse. No, they're alright. Alright, I'll talk to one of these goofs. Hey, buddy. How you doing? Let's talk. Let's have us a chat. Dema Imon Inomdung. Hello, it is good to see you. What do you do for a living? You're a stonecrafter. Do you have a job for me? Oh, apparently people just have jobs now. Creature of the night has our people cowering in fear. The shady shadow, pardon me, is a short walk to the north. Seek this place and kill Kuda Griffinstray, the bridegroom of the dusk creature. What? That's terrifying. This vile fiend murdered Heathery's sword shocks. Well, how dare he? Do you have any family? No. What about the surroundings? Can you tell me anything? We are in pastime moistened. That explains that first hut. Oh, wow. In the early summer of 53, the human Oaky Lovely Cradle was struck down by the Cyclops and the Gax Match Mime, the sparkle of intensity and pastime moistened. It's your capital, Lost Stream. I don't want to know what kind of stream that is. Alright, well, goodbye then. Goodbye! You don't want me to praise murder or rivers or fish or something like that? Alright, whatever. I don't think there's any shops in this area. This is just a little hamlet. You have to go to specific areas to get different shops and things from what I've seen. There's a lot of stuff I don't understand, so... Hey, this one doesn't have so many people in it. Soap, peasant, and mason. Cool, guys. Alright, cool. You're doing good. Let's take a look at our silly old selves here. What have we got? We got fiber clothes. We have a spear, which is weird, because I didn't pick any spear-related anything. And dog leather pants. Those are our drum pants. A sea nettle jellyfish to eat. And a large copper dagger, I imagine, is for skinning things with. Or something. I don't know. I heard that there was something like skinning in the game, but, you know, what are you going to do? I don't know. So I'm going to put... Whoops. I'm going to put my spear in my backpack, because I'm not really a spearman. I'll just hang on to that, and I'll throw it at someone, probably. Another house up here. I guess we'll take a look inside. Whoops. Let me see here. There we go. Hello? Holy moly. What is that? It's a bone doctor. I wonder if I can talk to him about becoming doctored. Because I don't know if you can get healed in this. Greetings. You join me? Oh, I want a bone doctor. What about... Alright, will you help? I'm not hurt or anything. Oh god, are you going to tell me to do it too? Yeah, Kuda Griffin, the... bridegroom of the dusk creature. Okay, so we're gonna go have to bite the bridegroom of the dusk creature at some point here. Trapper. Alright, so let's see here. Our average size for a human. Let's read the description. His hair is extremely long. Ears are fuse-lobed. It's a very deep voice. Yes, yes I do. He is average size, extremely short nose, eyebrows are dense, bronze eyes are round, head is somewhat narrow, hair is ochre, skin is pale brown. Sounds about right. And there's also an attributes page here. I've got high agility and everything else is pretty much just average, so. Alright, let's go ahead and take a walk, see how far away our death is. It's up to the northeast a little bit. Yeah, this is the little hamlet thing that we were at. There's a fortress up here. Looks like it's just above me. There's the camp. I see it right there. You cannot travel through the lair. It's not a camp. It's a lair. A fucking lair. Let's look at... There's no clouds over us, so... Alright, we're gonna stop here and travel to the lair of the night thingy. See if we can bite our way to glory. Take a couple small salt rocks. I'll take 4 of them and put them in my bag. So anyway, yeah, what I was saying was I know a lot of you guys can't handle this kind of game. If you're the kind of person that doesn't like the look of this kind of game or whatever, you're probably not even watching at this point, so I don't know why I'm bothering. What the fuck is that? But, I'm gonna do these in large sets, probably. Whatever it is, I lost it behind something. I can't quite see it. I spotted it at one point, but... Oh, no, it's gone. That's even more troubling than when it was there. Where... What was it? Where's my objective? Apparently not on the map, or either that or I'm right on top of it. Oh, there it is. There's the shadow of where it once was. Oh, I see. It's like a little pit in the ground or something. A hatch cover. Huh. That's new. Let's go investigate. Looks like it's open. Okay, we're gonna go down Hatchville. However we... Whoa! Coins. Fat loot. Cobalite amulet. Some human kidneys. And lots of coins. What is that there? Chopped human liver and some skin and a skull. I'm gonna start sneaking now. What the hell? Is that a skeleton? Yeah, skulls. Great. Well, I'm definitely taking these coins. I don't want the sandal. I'll take some prepared human intestines. And this coin here. What else you got? Human tripe. Another coin. Take the amulet and wear it. You know, I gotta be blinged out. Human bone meal. Sounds like a great meal. Is it like a TV dinner for Dwarf Fortress? Some skulls and some bone meal. It's all flashy. An iron shield. I am taking that. Some guy's skin. I don't like this place. No, I don't want it in my backpack. I'm gonna put the intestines in my backpack, and I'll also put gold coin in my backpack, and I'll remove the sexy shield that I stole. See. Now, what is this shield? Encrusted with finely crafted morion. Right, it's got morion spilled all over it. Oh my god. Yummy. Human brain. Delicious. Human sweetbread, and someone's fat, and human meat. This is horrifying. Why did they send me here? Well, I guess maybe they figured I was a biter, so they, you know, send him in for some stuff to bite. I'm taking this human meat and human sweetbread, though. That sounds delicious. Oh, I don't have anywhere to put the human brain. Light glove. What's here? Human meat. Alright, I'll use the human brain as a throwing weapon. More human meat. Spleen. A bronze mace. I'll put that in my bag. I'm cool with that. Nothing here. Left glove. Copper chain leggings. I will wear those. There, we've got some armor now. protect our legs. That's good. That'll mean we're more difficult to knock over, which is sort of like a way of saying instant death in adventure mode. Oh god. There it is. The bridegroom of the dusk creature. Prepare to die. Where is it? Copper coin, someone's skin, human fat, prepared human lung, and someone's skull. I don't see this bridegroom visibly anywhere. Oh hell, it's the N tilde. Okay, let's take a look at this thing. Limb-wise, it's got a tail. Other than that, a large three-eyed humanoid. It has a narrow tail and its joints are backward. Its black skin is warty. You will know why you fear the night. He is corpulent. I'm gonna get obliterated by this thing. Okay, I'm gonna step back a pace. No, I'm not. I can't see it anymore. What is that cheese-looking thing by it there? Oh, that's fat. Oh, shit! He's blotted me. Oh, and I'm trapped into a corner. That's just great. Okay, I need to throw this brain at it real quick. The spinning human brain strikes the bridegroom of the dusk in the upper body, bruising the skin. He missed me, I counter-strike, and I bit him in the lower leg and latched on firmly. So let's shake him around by the teeth, and I lost grip. That's okay, I've got a hand here, so I'm gonna grab with my right hand. I'm glad I have that shield. Let me see if I can grab the throat with my hand. Jumped away. I'll try that again. Whoa, something happened there and I missed it. I hope I'm not dead yet. I'm gonna grab the throat. I grabbed him with the throat from behind. I'm gonna wrestle. I'm gonna choke throat. I adjusted my grip, which means I failed. Wrestle. Choke throat. No. Alright. How about I... Let's see here. We've got normal strikes against the head. I'm gonna bite him in the head. Bite. You bite the bridegroom of dusk creature in the head, tearing the fat and bruising the muscle. Alright, so let's, I'm gonna wrestle with my tooth on the head. I didn't mean to release it. Let's see here. I'll wrestle using my hand. I'm gonna choke the throat again. I placed a chokehold. Alright, and... No, I've already got the good... I got the good chokehold there. Let's see, what's he doing? Punching me. Alright, he's punching me somewhere. I got an easy strike on the lower body. Can I get anything? I've got the head held, so... Can't quite strike the... It's an impossible strike on his head. Yeah, this new combat system is really cool. I'll take the upper body, and I will shield bash it. He loosened the chokehold. Choke. Damn it. I'm gonna release. Actually, I'll just release. And what I'll do instead is, I'm gonna grab him by the head if I can, and see if I can gouge out one of his three eyes. The head. Oh, I jumped away. Try that again. On the head. There we go. Alright, now I'm gonna wrestle, and let's see here, we can gouge the right eye. I can pinch it. Or something. Oh no, we're gouging. Okay, gouge the center eye. Gouge the bridegroom of dust center eye with your right hand, tearing it apart. I like that. Let's see here. We can gouge the right eye. No, it didn't work. But we're doing good. We're not dead yet. Gouge the right eye. No. Alright, let's do another bite here. What we got? Easy strike on the arms. No, there's nothing good there. I'm gonna go back to gouging here. I'm gonna pinch him in the... Oh, whoops. That didn't work. Wrestle, and I'll gouge the left eye. No, not the eyelid. I guess its right eye's already gone, maybe. No, right eye. No. Alright, what do we got here? Easy and tricky, and... I'm gonna go ahead and bite him in the upper body. I'll bite him. Nom. Nom 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 nom. Strikes at you, but the shot is blocked. I'm laying down. I need to stand up. There we go. Let's see here. We're not grabbing him anymore, so I'll go back to just attacking him. Let me change my combat preferences here. Let's see here. Strike. No. Close combat. And we'll stand our ground, and then we'll do dodge away for charges. Alright, so what do we got here? Upper body strike. That looks like our only shot. Upper body, I'm gonna kick him. My left foot. And I missed. Counter strike, but misses as well. Ooh. Nothing good there, so let's wrestle him. With my right hand, I'm gonna grab him by the tail. Oh, jumped away. Let's try that again. You know what, this might be a good spot to strike because no, maybe not. Alright, I'll get faster as this is I go. I'm gonna grab your tail. Hey, give me that tail. Stop it! Stop jumping! Jumpy McJumperton. Jeez! Fuck it. Let's see, we can do something with the left lower leg there. It's a normal strike with a fairly solid chance of hitting. I'll bash him with the shield there. I missed. Alright, so we got one of the eyes gouged out, but... hey, there we go. Alright, we'll do the left upper arm here. I'll bite it. Nom! Latched on firmly. I'm gonna shake him around. Shake left upper arm. Oh, broke my grip. Okay, let's try and... I want to bite him in the head. I'm going to go... Oops. I missed. No, I don't want to wrestle. Head. There we go. Easy strike. Very square. Now that's the lower body. Head is difficult. Alright, we'll go for the head anyway. Bite. I missed. Upper body. We'll go ahead and bite there. This is going to be a long fight as a biter. Jumped away. Difficult head, but we're going to go. I really want to bite this thing in the head. I'm going to shake him around by the head with my tooth. Yep. Head. Uh-oh. Oh, no, I'm bleeding and I fell over. All right, let's see what happened. Strikes you in the right foot, bruising the skin. Latched on. Oh, he bit me in the foot. He's learning from me. Shook me around by the foot. An artery in the right foot has been opened by the attack. Many nerves have been severed, and a ligament has been torn. Let me take a look at my health here. Am I able to stand? No, I can no longer stand, and I've got some sensory and motor nerve damage. And heavy bleeding. Alright, that's it. It's time to pull out the big guns. I'm going to pull out my mace. The bronze mace that I picked up. No, I want to remove the mace from the backpack. Derp. Remove it. And take out the bronze mace. Alright, I'm going to attack him now. Lower body. Easy strike. Completely square. Strike. Wait, that didn't work. What the hell? Where's my mace? Is it in my hand? Iron mace and bronze mace. Oh, I'm striking with... the shield is my primary weapon right now. Let me take a look here. Lower body, strike with the shield, bash with the bronze mace. There we go. I missed! Punched me in the left foot and kicked me in the lower left back tooth. And the severed part sails off in an arc. Kicked my tooth out. Your lower left back tooth. This is not looking good, people. I am probably gonna die. I'm hitting them with my offhand with a crappy mace. Shit. Got nothing I can do there. Could throw... I'm gonna throw this shield. No, I need that. I'll throw this... spear... at him. Strikes in the lower body and lodged firmly in the wound. And... I'm glad I didn't throw my shield. Shot... fucking blocked like a million times there. Alright, so I'm gonna wrestle with the... see if I can... I don't have a free hand now. I'll grab my upper arm and try to grab that spear. Jumped away. Okay, so I'll just do a... oh, he kicked me in the lower arm with the side of his left foot. All tricky strikes. All of them tricky strikes. Oh man, he's kicking the shit out of me. Grabbed me by the ear with his hand. That's not good. Wrestle using right ear. Break grip. Let go of my ear. I struggled in vain. I'm getting tired. Oh, and I got a mortal wound. Punches you in the upper body with his left hand, bruising the muscle and bruising the left lung. Something else happened, too. Kick me in the right lower leg, bruising the muscle through the thing, and strike at you with the shotted block. So, that punch to my chest turned out to be a mortal wound. Having trouble breathing. Okay, so let's take a look at our wounds here. Got a whole lot of wounds. Yeah, we're gonna lose this fight. But, that's how it go. My right foot is torn apart. In moderate pain, minor pain in my right foot, fat, muscle, artery torn, bleeding. I'm gonna bleed to death soon. That's just how it is. Let me take a look at my chest area, the upper body. Bruising all over my upper body, that's it. Huh. But I am having trouble breathing. Let's read a description. My lower left back tooth is gone. There's no way I can get away from this guy. I guess I could try to break his leg or something like that. I'm gonna grab with my right upper arm his right lower leg. I grabbed him, okay. Alright, and I'm gonna wrestle with my arm. I'll do a takedown. That didn't work. I'm still mortally wounded and bleeding. Here we go, I got a solid shot on his lower body I can take, and I'm gonna take it. I'll bash him. I bashed him in the lower body with my mace, bruising the fat. That didn't hardly do anything. He let go of my ear, but then he kicked me again in the foot and struck at me, but the shot is blocked. Let's see here. I attacked him, but he jumped away, does some stuff. Let's just get this over with. I'm dead. Oh, God. Ew, he bit me in the eyelid, and he's shaking me around by it. You dickhead. You absolute dickhead. Alright, I got an easy square strike on the body here. I will bite him, as I am a biter. I missed. Oh, great. Yeah, tearing apart the right eyelid skin. Gross. Punching me. I'm surprised I'm not dead yet. I'm gonna roll. Stop latching onto me, asshole. Let me go. I'm done fighting you. You win! I surrender! Let me go! Oh. Kicked me in the head with his left foot, bruising the muscle, jamming the skull through the brain and tearing the brain. You have been struck down. Okay, so as you can see, biter, not the most efficient combat preference. So we're gonna go with something that'll last a little bit longer. I said at the beginning I was just gonna sort of have this as a throwaway character. So there was Nod Drum Pants, the pants drummer. From Nodsville. There it is. You can see I've got a little tweaking to do. I need to get the game to run a little bit better. I had to switch it to standard print mode, and I think that might be screwing up the performance. I also don't know what to do about the FPS cap and all that kind of bullshit. It says it's recording at 30 FPS, but it's also giving me crazy screen lag and control lag when I'm recording, so I don't know what's going on there, but we'll figure it out. Onward and upward, and so it goes. And there's nothing left to do but have another adventure.